Your why is going to get you out of trouble. Your why is going to keep you from messing up on your own goals and your dreams and ambitions. Your why is the single defining factor that is going to give you purpose in this world. And if you don't have one, you're going to be drifting through life and wasting the gift you've been given every single day until your last breath. Now you tell me, is that what you want out of life?
Good afternoon, Ned.
This is different.
I know.
We're not that much different. We recorded in the afternoon, I think, last week. Or was it the evening?
Who knows?
Who knows?
It changes constantly.
We don't have like a consistent schedule. And that's fine because none of us, we still work day jobs. Mm-hmm. So
school.
That's completely fine.
Personal
right,
lives.
School. There's a lot going on.
Always.
A lot going on. So I actually just want to get started. Do you?
Yeah, let's jump in. Let's do it.
Okay. All right. Brent, this was your idea. We talked about someday revisiting our earlier episodes that they weren't the best to us. Everybody seems to love them, but I'm just like, I grit my teeth all the time. But something about this episode was really important for you to do. Like, he was like, can we please put this in here somewhere before episode 30? Episode 30 is like a big episode for us, as is episode 25. Why don't you explain the reason, like, give us some additional context as to why this was so important for us to do again?
Let's see, a reason. I think it goes back to just creating a motivation and focusing on the reason why you choose to be in comics, why you choose to have a passion in creating characters and forming a universe. You gotta refocus on that. And I needed that. I really think it was a very important episode that we did, which was number one. And I think it's a good reminder.
You had some kids, though, right?
What's that?
You had some kids that you used to
work
with.
That's right. Now
right.
I remember.
That's
boom.
What I wanted to. Uh-huh.
Boom. I got you. I was just talking in general. I was like, well, you know. So this came back about a week ago for me. I was reflecting with my time at the teen center. Just a reminder for what I've done before. I was a adolescent counselor / clinical intern. It's kind of like a therapist in training. I worked with adolescent teens from 13 to 17 that struggled with addiction as well as mental illnesses, which could be anxiety, depression. It could be behavioral issues. So when I was at the teen center, to build rapport with our patients, I turned to comics. I turned to my love of creating. So our teens came in. They were pretty much given no technology. They had to leave their phones when they did school. The computers were monitored. They were completely isolated from the outside world. So that way they focused back on themselves and what their sobriety meant, as well as focusing on what they need to do for therapy. So during that time, it was hard. And I remember introducing comics as well as showing them my own characters. And I took it a chance to introduce these kids to art and to reinforce things that they love, which were their passions, and really find out that they can do things without drugs or do things without getting in trouble. They can just focus back on natural, I would say, highs in life, which is creativity, imagination, being able to produce something, be able to connect with another person by touching them in a different way, either through words, through art, through a conversation, So last week I was really reflecting back on some of the notes that the kids wrote in. A lot of these kids, I took a little bit more of a mentor role with certain kids. We weren't supposed to have favorites. However, you still build a relationship with kids. You just click on a personality level. And a couple of these kids I would always click with was the artists are these really creative kids. And I just remember just loving them unconditionally and really pushing them with their art as well as characters. The funny thing is our first version of our character development, which goes into our e-guide of Unleash the Soul, I had that and I actually gave it to him and I saw how beneficial it was and have those conversations. And I was just going through some old notes and it was just amazing to hear what these kids had to say about me. And it really validated my purpose into why I did things. And again, a more personal note, currently I'm unemployed. I got let go at a current job. Besides the teen center, I was working at another treatment center. Due to low sentences, I got let go. So I was really questioning where my purpose was in therapy. If I should get a regular job, should I job search for another position within the field? So I was getting really discouraged, even though I've been devoting a lot of time with my creativity. Without really refocusing back on the why I did therapy, why I choose to be creative, was tampering with my creativity. Even though I had all this time available to me, I was limiting myself due to a lot of these negative thoughts I was having or negative beliefs I was believing in myself. So it was really nice to refocus on hearing what these kids had to say or seeing the artwork of what they draw and saying, hey, I can't wait for our characters to be as great as your characters. I can't wait to go to art school and then like message you later and show you what I've done. And that just, it just meant so much to me to just hear that. And that really refocused me on why I choose to do therapy is to help people. And why I choose to be a comic book creator is I love connecting to people from a story standpoint. I like creating characters that I see in my own perspective of worldviews and creating those stories to have an impact. Sorry, I kind of like zoned out in the moment of talking.
No, there we're done. That's the end of the show. Thank you guys for tuning in. We'll see you. Sign up.
So I got in the zone with that one.
It's great. And I don't know, somewhere in your story a couple weeks ago, last week, whenever it was, you had mentioned that one of your kids had found like this new purpose in life because of the art. He didn't have to turn to drugs or whatever it was anymore because he was embracing his why. He found his why. And I thought that was beautiful. And it really goes back to the importance of having your why, discovering your why in the first place, and then harnessing that why to carry you through so you don't quit. Because it's easy to quit. This is hard work. It's not as easy as people may think. 5 years and we're just getting started. Messed up along the way. If I knew what I knew now, it probably wouldn't have been 5 years, but it's been 5 years. And through that period of time, you need something to carry you through. And much like this kid that Brent worked with, you have to look inside and you have to find that thing. Because if not, you'll turn to other things that are destructive. And you'll ruin yourself. So you have to find the positive why within you and use that to carry you through those dark times, those hard times, those downswings. And that's what we kind of wanted to revisit today. How to overcome the desire to quit by discovering your why. So Brent, why don't you kind of start? Because it's really easy to quit. That's just like, I don't know about you, but I think this is prominent in our generation. I was not allowed to quit in my household. If we started something, we had to finish it. It was just a hard up. You cannot quit. You will stay here the entire year, whether you like it or not. I will take you. I will take you to the class, the karate class, whatever it was, but you cannot quit. I don't care how much you don't like it. You don't have an option. So I was raised knowing that there was no option out. I had to finish. I couldn't quit. So I was raised that way. And some people aren't raised that way. Some people don't get that nugget, that gem in life, where their parents have said, you can't quit. Some people's parents give them that out. They give them that comfort just to give it up. So for those of you who have that out, who have that comfort, who have the sense that you can just go ahead and quit everything, no, you can't. That's just not a good thing to build your character with. Quitting is just an easy thing to do. You have to build some tenacity. You have to build character. And the only way you do that is by sticking things through and stick. I understand some things are an exception. You should quit drugs. You should quit alcohol. I'm not talking about not quitting those things. Those are bad things. I'm talking about if you're starting a comic project, finish the project. My example for this weekend, I had promised that I would write this course, this free course for people who used to follow me, my old business geeky dreamer. Forgot about the course. Sat down yesterday for 3 hours, wrote 7,600 words, wrote the entire course. Finish what you start. I went on a tangent there.
It's okay.
So I'm going to hand it over to you.
No, you went in the focus like I did. You're like in the zone.
Right.
So I'm going to piggyback off of Ed. So let's get to why we have this idea of why it's easy to quit. And piggybacking off of what Ed was talking about, it goes back to whether your experience was. Either you were taught this as a character trait to imply in yourself, as it was with Ed, or you had to self-discover it within yourself, which is why I had to do in my journey. So something that stands out to me is don't be afraid to fail in life. And what I mean by this is don't be afraid not to try. It's so easy to give up and just quit. All you have to do is just try. Put an effort in. Just try something. And for me, I know that the biggest regret that I could possibly do is not even trying. And this is far worse than knowing that you didn't even try in the first place. So when I think about quitting as a negative belief, I really think that we're telling ourselves, hey, just give up. It's this internal dialogue that we have in our heads that takes place in our mind. And that belief is our perspective, okay, which is what we see. And that affects our worldview as well as determines what we see on an abstract, what our filters are with different things that we see, as well as the structure information that we receive about the world around us. So you're probably sitting there and saying, what the heck did Brent just say? Okay, well, in English, Brent. So this is what I'm going to say. Our perspectives of how we see the world can be molded and shaped by these core beliefs that we have, which are our own ideas, as well as reasons behind why we act upon things. So I want to ask you these two questions about beliefs. What is the belief that you have for comics? So this is your worldview of how you see comics. What do you think about it? How does it make you feel? Remember the times when you first read comics or watched an animated cartoon or saw a big screen film with superheroes. What was that experience to you? What did that do? How did that change you on a deeper level? So the next question that goes off of this one is, what is the belief that you have for creating? So for example, when I'm speaking about this, is if I believe that I cannot create a character, guess what? I just reinforced a negative message that I just told myself that I cannot do it. A negative message. I just reinforced it. And taking it a little bit further, I think about if I believe that I cannot create characters or comics and just quit and just give up, I just reinforce that negative message and it becomes a false belief in myself. And it's so much easier just to quit. It is. The challenge is try. The challenge is moving forward and knowing that you have a goal to set. Finish an issue. Finish 5 pages. Finish the drawing. Finish the dialogue. You have to believe in that. And what you can do to counter this belief, this goes back to positive psychology. Ed's mentioned this before, and I've read upon this before in it through school, is you have to challenge these negative beliefs that you have. You have to believe that I can accomplish creating a comic book without needing to quit. And you have to replace those negative messages with a positive message about your creativity.
You meant channel the positive energy.
Positive message. I don't know where energy came from, but we can talk about energy as well. It could be energy, it could be messages, it could be anything. So summing up what I just said is you have to try. Quitting is easy. You need to understand what your belief is with comics, as well as why you are creating characters and writing stories or drawing.
Mm-hmm.
Really refocus and reflect back. Are these negative messages that you're telling yourself? And if so, what are you going to do about it to turn it into a positive?
Right.
What is limiting yourself? And you have to figure that out. Because if you don't, that's going to put, as I said, limitations. And guess what? You're never going to accomplish something. And that separates people from the doers to the people who do not do anything.
Mm-hmm.
And what I mean by that is you're going to have a person that is going to accomplish creating a comic because he believed in it. He challenged those thoughts. He believed in himself. Or you're going to be the person that sat there and said, I could have, should have, would have.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I know for me personally, I don't want to live with that regret. So it's far worse for me to try and fail at it. At least I accomplished it and actually produced it.
Right.
And then you live and learn and you grow from that.
And I have to be honest, there have been times where I have wanted to quit. It gets to you time and time again. It's not like I'm always on the up and up. There are, I just told Brent and Tim in our meeting Friday that Arclight is on a huge upswing right now. But I told myself earlier that day, you need to prepare for the downswing that's coming, because that life is like that. There's upswings and then there's downswings. It's a balance, it's a rhythm, it's a pattern. And in those downswings, you need your why to carry you back up to the upswing. There's no room for quitting. You just can't give up and stop because it gets too hard. Toughen up. That's all I got to say about that. But what you also, you also need to get into the business of playing the long game. Technology is a beautiful thing. I am thankful that we can be on Skype recording a podcast for people all around the world. 20 years ago, heck, 15 years ago, 12 years ago, we wouldn't have been able to do this. So it has its benefits, but it also has this massive drawback. It kind of has given us like this short-sighted view of success. If something doesn't get the numbers or social following we think it should get, we think it's a dud. We're done. That's it. Let's quit. And that's just not the case at all. Everything can't be an instant win and an instant success in this microwave society that we live in. I said this on Snapchat. If you follow me on Snapchat, you would have gotten this message earlier. You have to sustain yourself when the instant wins and the instant successes don't come that often. You have to have something to carry you in between, though, because they're not going to come often. They'll pop up every once in a while. But when they don't, you can't from instant to instant drag yourself through the mud in this oh woe is me type of attitude and think that's fine, because it's not. You have to have a why to be able to pick you up and carry you from instant to instant. We're not popping popcorn here. We're actually making, planting and growing the kernels. We're not sticking anything in a microwave. Plant your seeds, tend to your harvest, the soil, let it grow. You need to water, you need to nurture. You can't plant a seed and an hour later come back and expect corn to pop up. It doesn't work like that. It takes weeks and weeks and weeks to grow that seed into a plant. So during that time, as you are waiting, farmers don't get frustrated because the corn doesn't pop up in a day. They know what they got to do. So while that plant is growing, there are other things that need to be tended to. You have to play the long game. It's going to take time. We play the long game here. More on that on episode 26. But we play the long game. We have a why. Our why allows us to play the long game. There's another thing I didn't even plan on saying. Depending on what your why is, you're either going to play the long game or the short game or a little bit of both. You actually should play a little bit of both. You have to have long-term goals and short-term goals. Hmm. But your why can't be, oh, I want to make millions of dollars. And that you expect that to sustain you over the long game, because it won't. We have never brought up money like that in that context. We have said, yeah, we need cash flow, but we need cash flow in order to produce more of what's been working of us, to increase our production for the podcast, to increase the output and quality of the mini issues. We need money to move. We need money to employ people full time, so this is all we can do all day, every day, and still get a paycheck at the end of the day. It's not to make $1 million. It's not to make $1 billion. The cash flow is to sustain us. That's what a business has. You have to sustain. You have to be profitable. But you have to have a why to get that cash flow and sustainability and to be profitable. And you get that by playing. You have to build assets. You have to do things in such a way that allows you to be sustainable. You have to figure out what, you have to dial your why exactly right to who and what you are, what you plan to do, so you can get through that desire to want to quit all the time. You have to have purpose. You have to take responsibility for that purpose. Yeah. We're going completely off
script. So this goes to, it's okay. This goes to a mindset. I mentioned earlier about belief, these messages that we have, that we tell ourselves, that come up randomly, or things that we believe based on our experiences. All goes back to your mindset. You need to be aware where your thoughts are coming from. And what I mean by this is you need to learn how to think. You can train your thinking. Your life is shaped by your thoughts, and whether they are positive or negative, you have a choice to entertain them or not. You give purpose and value to either positive thoughts or negative thoughts, and that's a choice. Mm. Whether you want to entertain them or apply them, at the end of the day, that is all on you. There's no excuse to it. You have to keep your mind off of things that don't help you. Think positive. Positivity is so key with creativity, imagination, accomplishing your goals, what you want to do in life, how you interact. Everything goes back to positivity. Mm-hmm. So you need to learn to be mindful and how to apply this practice that I've learned over 2 years, which is called mindfulness. And you think, Brent, what's mindfulness? What is this humble jumble you're talking about? And yes, I have spoken about myself twice in the third person, but it's okay because I'm cool like that. And I think I can. But anyways, mindfulness is all about being present in the moment. You're noticing your negative thoughts, your positive thoughts. And when these negative thoughts come up, you have to counter them with positive thoughts. For instance, I suck at drawing. Well, if you keep telling yourself, I'm going to suck at drawing, I can't do it. Guess what? You can't do it. But you sit there and challenge that thought. I suck at drawing. Well, Brent, you're trying. Why don't you study more tutorials on YouTube? Boom, you just challenge that negative
thought. That's what I used to do back in the day when it was just me doing the art. I wasn't the... everybody could, you know, say, oh, hey, you're so great. I'm like, no, it's not. But in that time when I couldn't, you know, really get hands and feet and the facial structure and stuff together, I would, you know, I would say that. I would say, I'm not that good, but I have to get better because my... my why was, I have to get better because the team is depending on me. If I don't do it, nobody's going to do it, and it's not going to get done. So I had to go ahead and learn, rapidly learn, like I learned on hyperspeed, to get things in order and in place for me to do what I had to do. You have to flip, like you said, the script on that negative. You have to have a why. What's the purpose? There's something bigger than you there. Your why has to be bigger than you. It just can't be about you. It has to be about other people. And that's what really gives it that fuel to be a good why, to carry you through whatever you're going through. But that's all I had to say on that. My bad.
No, you're good. You're good. So mindfulness has multiple components to it. And I'm just going to focus on one. There's a skill set that has three principles to it. It's called the what skills. You observe, you describe what's taking place, and you participate. So for the content of this episode, I'm really going to focus on participating. So by participating, what I mean by this is being aware or having awareness. So we can be in the moment, which allows us to step back from our lives and our thoughts and be aware that we are alive in this moment. We're experiencing creativity and using our imagination. You just hear that? Just being present with your creativity, being present with your imagination. We get so caught up by distractions with social media, negative thoughts, what our responsibilities are. Just embrace creativity, embrace imagination. I want you to practice this skill. And I want you to be mindful of what I'm going to say. This is going to be a challenge. I want you to really apply this. If my teens can do it, if I could teach a 13-year-old to do that, there's no excuse why you can't do this. So you ready? Here's the challenge. Try participating on one activity, either creating, writing, or drawing. This can apply to anything as well. For instance, dishes, okay? If you want to apply this to your daily life besides comics. Next time you sit down, I want you to either create a character or write a story or decide to draw. I want you to solely pay attention to the activity. Concentrate only on that activity. Anything else that comes up, push it away. Just focus on that activity. Set up a situation. You know this. What is the environment where you can channel your creativity? Is it in complete silence? Do you like being out and people with loudness? And this goes back to what energizes you. Are you an introvert where you channel things by yourself, or are you an extrovert where you channel by people? Find those things of where these environments are that can help fuel your imagination and creativity. And I want you to not be bothered by the distractions when you try this. Now I want you to notice everything about what you're doing and try to do it really well. So if you're going to draw something, do it really well. Focus, let's say you're drawing a hand. Focus on just drawing that hand. Work through it. And you know what's going to happen? You're going to have an experience. You're going to experience creativity on a deeper level, your imagination on a deeper level. And you're going to ask this question to yourself, what does it feel like for you? Gosh, I know when I'm in the zone of creating or writing, I get this inner peace. It smooths me in a way. It acts as a coping skill where all the crap in my life gets completely thrown away. And it's just fully engaging in your creativity and imagination. Appreciate the beauty and peace of creativity. I feel closest to my higher power, which is God. And when I'm experiencing the moments of creativity and exploring my imagination, that's where I feel connected. I feel almost like this universal connection with the universe. It's very profound. It's very real. And I'm sure you have experienced this.
Mm-hmm.
Focus on one thing in this moment. Okay. Go back to that. Like making one realistic goal. I want you to just make one goal a day. I've had to do this. I've tried to do multiple goals, but guess what? Just focus on one, on your comic, and staying away from everyday negative distractions in your life. Social media, what you tell yourself, life stressors, just channel your creativity and imagination. So another thing I want to bring up is it's all about effectiveness. So what do you mean by this, Brent? To focus on what works for you. Do what needs to be done to accomplish your goal of becoming a creator, a storyteller, or artist. You need to stay away from judging or making assumptions about yourself. Okay. Those are the things that are going to bog you down. Those are the things that are not going to allow you to accomplish what you want to do in this life. You need to not have that kill your passion. That is a passion killer as a creator. You need to really focus on your objectives. Make small objectives for the day. And make those small realistic goals so that you can set those things to accomplish. And guess what? You get to checkmark them. You feel something with that. You feel accomplished with that. You know, and that's all about validating and validation. Well, Brent, what do you mean by validation? Okay, well, validation is key to success. Okay. Validating is an encouragement statement that you say to yourself. Validating our thoughts and our emotions will help you calm yourself and manage your emotions more effectively. Okay. This also challenges your creativity. Validating yourself will help you accept and better understand yourself on a deeper level. We all want that, which leads us to have a stronger identity of who we are and have better skills at managing our negativity in our life. Self-validation helps you to find wisdom and actually clarity for positivity. So here's the thing. Surround yourself with positivity. Change your environment. Either go to the beach, go to the library. Just focus on your creativity. That's where I'm getting at. Enjoy being a creator. And this goes back to what is causing you distress. Can creating characters, stories, and marketing your final product be a stressor? Yes, it can be. However, you decide whether or not you have this passion as a creator for comics and it becomes a stressor. You have that choice. If you enjoy doing this and this is your outlet, then it should not cause you stress. Be joyful with it. Be engaged with it. Notice the activity. Be in the moment with it. Creativity is fun. Enjoy it. Imagination enables you and me to create soulful characters, adventure stories, and draw beautiful portraits that we never thought were possible. And through those things, guess what? It impacts people. I know that's an element of my why, is to impact people. And it's a form of self-expression.
And I want to... Whew. Great.
Sorry.
Points.
I got in the zone again.
I know. I loved it. You have a passion for helping people. As I said earlier, it's almost like your why is like this bigger spiritual essence type of thing that you channel through all that stuff to get through everything. Because there are going to be days, again, where there's a downswing. There's going to be stressful days, but you need that to carry you through. You know, there are times where I've been completely out of it. Brent has been completely out of it. I've been in funks. Yeah. Brent's been in funks. We've both had bad days. We've both had disagreements. And we always don't feel like sitting down and doing this. We're recording a doubler today, and I don't feel like coming back from the gym and recording the second episode, but I know it's going to have to happen because Brent has to leave in a half an hour. This is going to be a long episode. But whatever, we still have to do it.
Gosh, man. Call me out on the podcast.
But we have a why. We started this with the intent to help people, help other people who are also in the trenches with us, who are also in the same situation. We just have 5 years worth of experience and stories and things that we can share with others to make their journey a lot more easier and a lot less hectic. Your why is going to get you out of trouble. Your why is going to keep you from messing up on your own goals and your dreams and ambitions. Your why is the single defining factor that is going to give you purpose in this world. And if you don't have one, you're going to be drifting through life and wasting the gift you've been given every single day until your last breath. Now you tell me, is that what you want out of life? And if you do, may God bless you. I'm going to pray for you because that is not what your intent in this world is to do, is to just drift through life doing nothing, wasting the gifts that you've been given. You have purpose. I don't care what anybody else has told you. You're not good enough. You're not this. You're not that. You are good enough. You do have purpose. You do have a reason for being here. We all have hardships in life. We all go through some sort of trauma. We all have bad days. We all have negativity in our life. We always have somebody in our ear telling us that, you know, we're not this, we're not that. We all have somebody, big or small, is hating. But you have to get through all that, and you actually have to sit up and tell yourself, stand up and say, yes, I do have purpose. I do have a why in my life. I am going to make a difference. I am going to leave my mark on the world. Somebody is going to know my name in some capacity. We're all given that potential. I don't know why anybody thinks that that is only given to a select few people. We're all born with it. We all have a chance to take it. But not everybody does. So, and I refuse to let that happen to me. So I push through. We all push through here at Arclight. And that's what you have to do. I am glad Brent pushed us into doing this episode again, because I feel like we're at a place where we can actually just really go in and we're not nervous like in episode one. And it's honestly the only reason why Arclight is still here. It's so easy to quit, as we talked about earlier, but you have to dig down into your soul, find what is going to carry you through these really bad times and turn that into your why. Because on everything, it's going to carry you when you have nothing left. There have been days where I have had nothing left. Last week, I was kind of like out of it. I don't know. We had a podcast recording our meeting. I just couldn't. I was just completely, I had no energy, no nothing. And it wasn't a great day, but we still had to do what we had to do, because we have to show up every single Thursday, every single week. We have to be here consistently. We can't let you down. We're here to help. That was our intent. That's what we said we're going to do. That's our promise. And we're going to fulfill it every single Thursday, except for on sabbatical week. But the way we're recording our episodes now, there actually might be an episode on sabbatical week, because we're doubling up on episodes. But good episode.
I love this episode. This is a good episode.
It is a good episode. Can we start getting into like Arclight's vision? And
okay. Yeah.
All right. So this is very important. This is like brand building 101, going back to that. You have to have a vision. You have to have a mission. You have to have a set of core values to fuel things. And Arclight's vision, I didn't realize this, but I had said this years ago to Jason and Jeff, but our vision is to become the Pixar of comics. That's the short of it. That's all I've been saying anytime anybody asks me, well, what is going on here? and people just get it, like the magnitude of that. The Pixar of Pixar is huge. Pixar is its own industry. To aspire to that is lofty. It almost seems impossible. Like, who are you? You know, the Pixar comics. But anytime I've told somebody that, you've experienced this as well, you're just kind of like, oh, wow, really? That's what you guys are doing? And that outset really fuels like everything that we do. In our mini issue session for issue number 3, we kept bringing up Pixar as we were creating the story. We kept making sure we were checking ourselves. Well, this really wouldn't make sense because she would do this. If we leave this out of the story, we're missing the heart of it. Well, we have to pay attention because now this is becoming Go-Girl and Bolt's story and not what we originally intended. We went through that process. We actually thought of, we put the story first, like we said, we always do. And we actually do. Story came first every single time. Every single time a new idea came up, how does it affect the story? And that goes back down into our mission statement. Our mission is to create enjoyable, memorable, and timeless stories and characters to entertain and inspire generations to come. And in order to do that, again, you have to put story first. You have to pay attention to what you're doing. And we were doing just that in issue number 3. We do it with Solace whenever we have an opportunity to work on Solace. Is his story there? Is it memorable? We did this with all the other characters. What's the theme? What's the overall message? What is their beliefs? What do they stand for? What do they represent? What is the grander idea here? So you can see how a vision and a mission really fuels the why of a project. And you have to tailor that to your own project or studio. You don't steal anybody else's. That's just, you're not going to get the same results stealing somebody else's. I learned that the hard way. In this copy and paste world that we live in, you can Google such and such's mission statement, copy, edit a couple things, paste it, edit a couple things, and be done with it. And let that be it. But don't do that. You have to come up with your own. It has to be from your core. If you're the visionary, who and what you are, your values are going to come up in the why for your project and your studio, for your vision statement and your mission statement and your core values. One of our core values is be a value to somebody. And that's what being a value through the podcast, being a value through the free mini issues, being a value through the time that we take to answer emails, to answer, rather reply to comments, to answer direct messages. See how it fuels everything else. You have to get to that point and that position with your studio, with your project, with your team, whatever the case may be. So I think we can go into like on our individual wise and then wrap it up. It's a good episode.
Sounds good. Gosh, I feel it. I can feel the energy and right. Stuff. So here's my why. It's going to be a little bit more different than the first episode. Again, that was our first time recording, and we were very nervous about things. And looking back and re-listening that over the weekend, I kind of sat there and was kind of amazed of who that person was and who I am today and how much I've grown and changed during that period. So I think of the motto, be who you needed when you were younger. This applies so much to my life. I apply this to my passions of therapy and comics. Therapy is providing somebody with guidance and being there for that person when they need help. providing them with skill sets and just being a listening ear and being a cheerleader with encouragement and saying, you can do this. You're stronger than that. You're better than that. You can get through it. That's why I do therapy. Why I do comics? Comics have always been something I've always loved. I was introduced to them by a babysitter when I was younger, a male babysitter, and he was so big into the X-Men. Now, I remember if we were role playing, he had my brother, who my oldest brother, special needs. He has cerebral palsy and he can't walk. He has a mindset of an 8-year-old. He's in his 30s right now. He has to be diaper changed and he has a caregiver 24 hours. Can't really communicate. So back then, Will did such an impactful thing that completely changed me and actually turned me on to comics. Was we were acting out. He had my brother as Professor Xavier. He was Wolverine, and I would always be like Nightcrawler or someone like hyperactive. Mm-hmm. And I remember that, and I remember watching the 90s cartoons. I remember him drawing. He was an artist. He drew comics for me. I just remember seeing that and being so engulfed by it. And we'd have conversations, and he would challenge me with creating that. Characters, and I created stories at a young age because of him. I never thought about that. I never looked back on that until this past weekend and seeing how much that person impacted my why and gave me a passion for comics. One babysitter that just cared. One babysitter that used the connection of comics and love to bring fun and to completely change my life and allow, you know, my comics as well as my creativity to be a form of self-care. And when I'm talking about self-care, I'm talking about what is an activity that you do that helps you cope with life. Comics is my coping skill, is my coping activity to deal with my personal struggles. It is actually counteractive to my stressors. So when I feel like I'm creating, I'm actually contributing. I'm actually feel alive. I feel connected. I feel like I have purpose. And your activity could be going to the gym. It could be drawing a picture. It could be going to the beach. Mine is being able to bring life and create a character. And when I see the final product and know that I created a personality out of it, it's amazing. It's almost like giving birth to a child or creating a kid. And with my characters, I always kept them at a surface level until I came to Arclight. I had some core principles that I applied with certain characters. And Solas was the first person I really personalized it. It was very hard and challenging for me because this was a reflection of myself, reflection of my older brother, reflection of a motivational speaker that I like, and just going there with the vulnerability and just really connecting with fans and the audience and even with myself on a deeper level. And this is being able to provide myself comfort and being able to have clarity to the personal struggles I with. And I'm very transparent about what I go through. I have ADHD, which you don't know is attention deficit hyperactive activity. So I have low focus. I struggle with time management. My attention span is like 0 to 100. Certain parts of my brain don't operate when they should be operating. And with this, I suffer from depression. I go through depression spells. I have anxiety. I have anxiety right now. You can't see it. I'm sure Ed can't hear it because I channel it now in a positive way. But if he would see me now, I'd probably smell really bad because I'm sweating. But that shit, you know, that's the anxiety aspect. And then I also have PTSD, which is post-traumatic stress disorder. And I have symptoms related to that with past trauma. And that was another reason why I wanted to do therapy. I went through some things that were very devastating traumas in my life. And I wanted to help other people. I wanted to be a listening ear. I wanted to help someone that I felt like I couldn't be done with me. I had to learn the hard way. I had to do that. And if I can be there for someone, that's great. And with Solas, I can't wait to introduce him in the Arclight universe. Ed's amazed about what I can do with him. And even it goes back to mini issue number 3. Like, I love it so much. That's going to be my favorite issue with, as Ed was mentioning about Bolt and Go Girl. We really focused on Go Girl. I love it. We were able to bring a very human element to her and made her very real. And I cannot wait. If this gets released and you guys have already seen it, let us know what you guys think. I love it. We poured a lot of time into that one. If you haven't seen the release yet, I can't wait for you guys to see it, because you know what? It touches on realistic aspects. It's bringing that Pixar element to the Arclight universe. This is what we're doing. Telling memorable characters that we can relate to. Telling these stories that we can have become our own reality, to escape our own reality of these stressors and engulf in that. Arclight characters to me are going to be your mentors. They're going to be people that you can relate to, and they're going to be your cheerleaders and your encouragers. That's what Arclight is to me. That's why I love Arclight so much, is that is to be able to help people and bring back that element which is really missing in comics. Giving advice and showing things and having these characters be like role models to our younger generation or to what you're even going through. And even for myself, and I'm sure with Ed. Mic drop.
I think it just goes back to my why to wrap it up. You know, it's about helping people for me and giving something back to the world. We create these stories to help, to inspire, to entertain, to make ourselves look in the mirror and ask the question, maybe I wasn't right about that, or maybe my beliefs aren't as accurate as I thought. Maybe I should approach this person differently. Maybe I should go try to talk to one of them. Maybe they all aren't the same. Maybe my religion is clouding my views and making me biased towards this group of people. Maybe my non-religion is keeping me from getting to know those who do practice religion. Maybe I should be more sympathetic to this person because they're going through this. Maybe we do all make mistakes. Maybe I shouldn't judge because my past isn't the best. That's the level of storytelling. That's the kind of characters we're creating. To heal the world at some minute, microscopic level. If we can do our part just for one person, then that why is fulfilled for me. And it's about leaving a legacy and mark on the world. We've had people message us and say, you know, thank you so much for doing this podcast. It's really helping me out. This is so valuable. That's what it's about. That's our focus. We put people first. We put our audience first. It's always about them and taking care of them. You take care of your people, they will take care of you every single time. The rule of reciprocity. We'll get into that episode 26. But that's how it works. And I also just want to be able to build something to sustain my family for generations to come. My mom really wants a summer home. I would really love to hand them a check for the full amount of that summer home and say, here, I just bought it for you. Here you go, Mom. Here you go, Dad. Thank you for all that you've done for me. As I said, your why has to be bigger than you. Nothing about that was about me. About my family and other people. It has to be larger than your own life. Otherwise, it's just not going to work. It's not going to apply. It's going to be really short-lived and very selfish. The world, you can't operate in the world as a selfish person. you will get very little back in life if all you do is take.
It goes back to what characteristics do you want to apply to your comic? Do you want to have integrity? Do you want to be transparent? Do you want to show compassion, kindness? What values do you have? That's where Ed's getting at. That's where I'm getting at. It's really, we're pouring into this. I brought psychology into this episode, and I never did that before. I did little bits of it. That's my strength. My other strength is comics, and I need to blend those two together. They're going to work together. They're going to be intertwined. And it goes back to what Ed said. It goes back to, we're doing this podcast to help people. I'm doing this for people who are struggling right now making a comic. I get that. I get that so much. With my thing at Lighthouse, if I could tell you all the stuff, how many times we wanted to quit as a team, the money wasn't there, we almost switched artists, everything was just going bad. But you know what? I kept going back to it because my goal was to create a comic book issue. I wanted that. That was a goal since I was a kid. And I never thought that was going to be possible. And guess what? 29 years old, I'm making that a possibility for myself. I am going to hang it up on my wall. And whether if it sells or not, I can at least sit there and say I made a comic book for myself as I wanted as a kid. I was able to achieve that goal. I did it. So with this wrap up with a quote, sometimes you have to be your own hero. Hear that again. Sometimes you have to be your own hero. That's all I have.
Right. You have to go.
I do have to go. I got an interview. So Everyone wish me luck with that. Yes. I want to say with this, thank you so much for the friend request. I've been getting messages privately through Facebook about how amazing the podcast has been, and that just means so much to me. And I know Ed loves hearing that. Engage with us. Our next episode is going to be really about engagement with you guys. Ask questions. Give us some. Just challenge us. We've been there and done that. We might not have all the answers, but guess what? We've been through the hustle and grind. So use us in a way that we can help you. We're not pros. We're not experts. We're not on the pedestal. I'm just your average person who's going to school just to help people. And I just want to tell stories with soulful characters and comic books. That's who I am.
Let's wrap it up. You got to go.
I'm going to go to the gym. Let's wrap it up, Ed. So, Mr. Superman shirt, getting pumped up for the gym. We need to get tremor on that.
I know.
That's what we need to do. We need to get you an Under Armour with the tremor symbol on that. So, Ed, where can they reach us at Arclight Comics?
On my Snapchat, Geeky Dreamer. That's where I want you to go. Focus. I listened to another Sean West episode where it was like, stop telling everybody to go 10 different places. Pick one. Snapchat, Geeky Dreamer. GEEKY Dreamer. Add me. I say some great things on there. At least I think I do. Brent, where can people go to find more about you in Lighthouse Comic Studio?
I would say just reach us out at Lighthouse Comic Studio at Instagram. I'm not going to go with Facebook. No more. The Facebook group would be there. Our posts are tagged through there. I want you to come to Instagram page. That way you can interact a little bit more. I'm more on that than Facebook.
Facebook and so down.
I can't do Facebook no more. So one of these days I'll give out Snapchat. Ed's still trying to convince me. I'll let you know when that comes. I'm still kind of weirded out about it, but we're getting there. I'm sure you'll see footage of me like it was posted a week ago. So I'm sure you're already seeing things that I don't even know about. So enjoy for your own entertainment.
Right. I'm going to have to upload you guys my story I did the other day.
Nice. All right. This was a fantastic episode. Apply it. Let us know what you think about it. Reach out to us. We love you guys. Keep believing. Keep doing what you have to do. And have a great week. And we look forward to doing more episodes with you guys.
Absolutely. Have a great day, y'all. Have an even more blessed week. Y'all, next Thursday, episode 25. Big episode. Oh, wait. We have to tell them.
Oh.
Episode 25. Big episode. We need your questions.
Oh, shoot. I was right.
We almost missed the entire opportunity to ask for questions. We need you to email support@arclightcomics.com any questions you have on any past episodes, anything you have for us that we can answer. This is going to be a reflective, listener-driven episode that we're going to do. So go ahead and do that. So with that, we're out. You gotta go.
All right, bye-bye.
Thanks, y'all. Bye.
See ya. Love that. Great episode.
Trippy!